And welcome back to Inland Empire Live on PEP. That's Monica. Art night.
Yeah, it's coming up.
Coming up. What are you going to do? Like finger painting or what's Monica going to do?
Oh, I'm
going to
buy every
here?
Piece I can possibly get my hands on. That's my
gonna,
goal.
You're not going to make art, create some art to have on display?
I do that enough at work. I am looking forward to enjoying everybody else's pieces and snatching up some of the unique ones.
Well, we have some pros in the house here on IEA today, Monica. We've got Ivan and Rebecca. Ivan is from the Art Institute of California, Inland Empire.
Yes, I am.
Rebecca Ward. All over the place, San Bernardino Valley College included, right? Thanks for joining us here on the show. So let me go with you first, Rebecca. So tell us a little bit about Art Night for people who might not be familiar with this event and what they might be able to see on Friday, April 21st and Saturday, April 22nd.
Definitely. It's going to be held in the Carousel Mall and in the downtown square. San Bernardino Valley College is going to be bringing not only their music department, the performing arts department, their dance department this year, as well as all forms of art that we have at our school.
Are you dancing?
I am.
I'm not saying that's just it, but are you doing anything else on top of
Yes, we're going to have some interactive dances. So we're going to be teaching some dance, as well as our young students that are about 5 and under are going to be help teaching a dance called Turn the World Around.
Do you want to do that? No. I'm sorry. I was going to put her on the spot. Can we do that dance right now?
No. I don't know if you remember Rebecca, but last year she was featured in our Art Night video as one of the singers and dancers, and she did this really cute little turnaround in the video. So
she's
that's
famous.
Probably
she's,
where you may
yeah,
have
she's
seen
a,
her.
She's a local Anyways. Celebrity.
Yeah,
right?
she is. She pretty yeah. much is. She's been in all of our stuff.
And last time she was on this show, she did a little, what was it, a hula?
I did.
Hula dance?
Yep, I did. We will have a whole hula team, too, that's going to be there of all different levels and ages.
You hula, Ivan? No.
No, not too good. I'll give it a shot, though.
Yeah,
but you're a great artist, right?
Yeah, I try to.
Monica, what were you telling me? There's an art on display of Ivan's?
Yep, we have one of his murals that he completed in last year's Art Night event. He was gracious enough to donate it to the city of San Bernardino, so right now it resides in the lobby of City Hall.
Wow.
And it will go with us. Wherever we go, that piece will continue to live on. And it's actually used in our current flyer as a backdrop. So Ivan has really made a big impression on all of us here and really amazing work.
Oh, thank you guys.
We also have a piece of art here in the studio here at IEMG. What inspires you? What brings the creativity out for you, Ivan?
For me, honestly, I think it's just everyday life and experience. Yeah, just interacting with people, connecting with people. What really inspires me is the backstories, people's backstories. That's something I could really draw from. So that piece, I had a lot of fun with it. Me and Alex got together and made a cool video. So it was fun. It was nice.
What can we look forward to this year?
This year, it's going to be what I consider an explosion of paint. We'll be doing a collage-style mural for the Art Institute of California Inland Empire, as well as a piece for San Bernardino City Hall. The second piece for City Hall will involve community interaction, so we'll have kids painting, parents painting. So it'll be a lot of community involvement. It's gonna be great.
Yay. Well, okay, I may partake in that one.
Really? Yeah, you might? Okay.
I need to leave my mark.
The Art Institute of California, i.e., how is that involved with Art Night? And do you see, like, a lot of people being, I'd say inspired, I know we're using that word a lot, but inspired to do some great things like yourself to be involved with an event like Art Night?
Oh, definitely. The Art Institute, they're involved on so many levels, from the students to the faculty. As far as bringing me in, the faculty has been great. I mean, I love them there. The students could be involved on so many levels. We have film students that could be shooting it. We have photography students taking photos. We have audio students that could perform some music. Me as a graphic designer, I could do live painting. Students that are advertising graphic design could create the flyers, get it out there. So the Art Institute and the City of San Bernardino working together has been this really great like forging of a bond. We've been able to make great things happen. So yeah.
And Rebecca, you've been with this event for a couple of years. How have you seen it evolve, change, bigger, better? I mean, how have you seen Art Night change?
Not only is it a two-day event, but we're pulling out all the stops. Our welding department's going to be there showing some of their work as well. And then we even have our film students are going to be showing some of their films that they've created. And we have our poetry that's going to be paired up with some dance movements and some art pieces that will be displayed.
Yeah, I believe they have over 100 artists that will be on display. So a lot to see.
It sounds like a big variety, right? Yeah. I mean, from chalk, like to welding, to everything in between there?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, what are some of the other disciplines of art we might see?
Not only will you see dance, but we just recently started up our instrumental program at our school. So you'll get to see some of our students performing on their main focused instrument.
So at San Bernardino Valley College, is it something that a lot of the art students, hey, whatever you're into, we want to see something on display or performance or something at art night?
Yes. Just about everything that we're doing this semester, we're going to bring on to this art night, and then we're also going to have a little showcase of our new production that we're doing in our theater program.
Oh, wow, so a lot going on.
Mm-hmm. Not chalk art, food.
Yeah.
So there'll be food trucks.
You
have to feed
food,
people,
Monica.
Right? I know, always. Yeah. It's bad sign. Yeah. And then obviously interactive programming with Art Institute of the Inland Empire, and then Valley College, and Parks is also going to be doing a little interactive painting session with kids and families and whatnot. So a lot to do.
And Ivan, I'm just curious, we're kind of running out of time here, but when you have an art piece, let's say for Art Night, which begins April 21st and 22nd, how early do you have to start preparing for that? I mean, is it months in advance? Was it last year? Was it maybe yesterday? I mean, how early do you have to start?
Hopefully not yesterday.
Yeah. Well, how early do you have to give yourself a head start to make sure it's done to the degree that you're happy with and have on display?
Definitely the second I hear about the opportunity, that's when I start, mind mapping and thinking about the concepts. So as much time as possible. For Art Night last year, I think I had about 3 months, so I was able to really take in what the city's going through, the people involved, and I was able to portray that and display that in the painting. So as much time as I could get, the better. Yeah.
Okay. And Rebecca, where can people get information on Art Night?
You can go to our Facebook.
SB Art Night.
There you go. At SB Art Night on Facebook. It's also going to be displayed for both the Art Institute and San Bernardino Valley College. We'll have it plastered everywhere.
Awesome. Well, Rebecca Ward, Ivan Preciado, we appreciate the time, and we look forward to see you on April 21st, Friday night, here in downtown San Bernardino at the Carrollton Mall.
And Court Street Square.
And Court Street Square, it's going to be awesome. All right, thanks, guys.
You're welcome.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you. Okay.
We'll be right back here on Inland Empire Alive. Well, thanks for watching this episode of Inland Empire Live. Monica, if you are down with art, tiny homes,
music,
you got a pet, prom night music,
everything.
Any of those things, what do you need to do?
You need to hit subscribe on this YouTube button just below here.
We're trying to get to 5,000.
Help us.
Yes, and they can be a part. Thanks to all our guests today, and we'll see you next time on Inland Empire Alive.